Alright, ladies and gentlemen, y'all already know what time it is, man. If you like the video, subscribe for more daily 2K content, and let's get right into it. NBA 2K21, help is on the way. I said, help is on the way. Hey, Mike Wong is back. He's tweeting. We got the latest tweet from Mike Wong 6 hours ago, and a whole bunch of stuff that everybody else. Also, Running 2K drops a big bombshell about NBA 2K22 and future 2Ks, and we got the mayors, man. So if y'all don't do nothing else, make sure y'all like the video, man, because every time y'all like the video, we get closer to our goal of 100K, and people can actually see the video when it goes out and stuff like that. Let me know who you voted for, and if you like the mayor whole thing, man, and all that good stuff, and let's just get right into the video right after this. Nino!
If you make it to C25, that's OG status. I was told you could be anything, just don't be average. Down bad, flat pockets, that shit made me a savage. Start hustling nonstop, don't plan on breaking that habit.
Y'all already know me, man. Never one for long introductions. I just want to get right to the news and get right to it, man. Check it out, bro. Let's just get Ronnie 2K out the way. Poor Boy Sin and Rival Day winning Mo Buckets have sizable leads. Whatever. Look, we already know who won. We're going to tell y'all about that in a second. But this is what he says. Love rep. A love rep guys getting a platform. That's what's beautiful about the mayoral system. It's only going to get better in future years. Now, if he's saying it's only going to get better in future years, does that mean that the mayor joint is here to stay and that the city in some way is here to stay, bro? I don't know, man. It seems like it's cool. Let me know if y'all like the mayor system down in the comment section. Do y'all think we should just have one president, just one representative of the whole 2K, and then he has some elected officials and those his mayors and stuff like that? I don't know. Or do y'all think it should just be cross-gen? And we just, cross platform, and it just be like, on one side, we'll have, PlayStation versus Xbox or whatever like that. Y'all let me know down in the comment section, man. Up next, we got amazing, Ronnie also tweeted, amazing for Drew Take Flight, Six God, and so much, let's say, so much that they're being celebrated as mayors. Okay, that's cool right there. And this is who all got Drew Take Flight, Mo Bucket, Six God, and Poor Boy Sin. So we knew who won yesterday. We talked about that on yesterday. And, everything is good. Everything is awesome. We got that out of the way. Now for the most important thing, Mike Wong is Mike. I say Mike Wong is Mike, man. Y'all drop a like if y'all are happy that Mike Wong is Mike. If y'all know who I'm talking about, BYKE, he's Mike, ladies and gentlemen. Check it out. Mike Wong tweets out, recent hotfix went in to fix the easy special delivery team takes and slight nerf to contact dunks. I haven't noticed, but I'm glad. I hope they don't tweak that too much. Let me know if further changes are needed. Looking into post hook exploits, which nobody uses. So we'll talk about that in a second. Fading threes and OP blindness badge. Any other badges? Need adjusting. Now, I'm not gonna lie to you, man. So look, I haven't seen no post hook exploits. Y'all gotta let me know if y'all saw that, bro. Like this is what makes me feel like Mike is a little bit out of touch with the game right now, bro. Because like I said, I've not seen any post hook exploits or any stuff like that. I just haven't seen it. It could be maybe I'm out of touch with the game, but I play the game every day. I think I would see it. I would have seen it by now, but I've not seen it. Maybe he's talking about current gen or something like that. Fading threes, definitely. And OP blindness badge. I don't think blindness is OP. I think it's the same thing that we've been dealing with. You just have to have a badge to do it now. Like, you know how we used to, it's always been get the dude on your hip. And once you get him on your hip, you know what I'm saying? You can just shoot the ball. So I myself, I've not seen it. I've not seen anything that I feel like it's just OP about the blindness badge. I do think it's necessary. The biggest thing I feel like the blindness badge does is it prevents one person from guarding two people, especially in Pro-Am, to where that guy can be on the side. He just runs to either one of them and you can't take the shot. I got blindness, I'm taking the shot. So I think it's a badge that's needed. But like, bro, then here we go. This is where we come to the other stuff, bro. I'm with Downwork on this. He said, blindness is fine. Thank you, Downwork. Blindness is fine. Explain to me why 6'7 power fours get Hall of Fame quick first step while 6'7 guards don't. I'd honestly like to know if that was a mistake or not, and what the rationale was. Of course, we get no response with that. My boy Swante says, finally, contact dunks and layups need to be nerfed more, or defense needs to be buffed. fades, fading threes, blinders, contested shots going in need to be nerfed dramatically. Lateral quickness and blow blinds need to be buffed. Rep shouldn't be 50% less different. Different when you're playing in different whatever, and more diverse dribbling. Now, I will say this. See, this is the part where I don't like where everybody gets to weigh in. Contact dunks and layups need to be nerfed. I don't even feel like that's a thing. I don't think those need to be nerfed. I think those are just fine where they are. But like I said, this is my opinion, right? My opinion might not necessarily reflect the opinion of somebody else. So I feel like that those are fine. I think that. And then like lateral quickness, I think that's cool too. I just don't understand and blow by. Like, I don't get blown by, but I got a lot of strength and I got interior on my guy. Like, I look at it like, it's like a chess match. Like I said, it's regular basketball, real basketball. If I'm pressing you, that's what you're gonna do, get by me. But you see this dude try to go in there and dunk on us, bro, you're not making that dunk on two people. Like, he would've made that dunk on most other people, right? But those two guys have a whole lot of interior. So you're not gonna make that dunk on them. And a lot of people don't make layups. Now the fades and the fading threes, I do give you that. Blinders can be toned down a little bit, but I don't think it needs to be toned down, you know, as much as people feel like it needs to be, you know? So like that's what I think, man. I just don't want them to turn the game into something that we don't recognize with a lot of passes. And he said, how the heck did they think playing different affiliations? Yeah, we don't care about that. Let me see. Contact dunks cruise. Let me see. It was good where it was after the recent nerf. The fix for special delivery was good, but can you nerf the phase? Yeah, everybody wants the phase to be nerfed, bro. Like that's really what it is. Mike also actually responded and said, look at that. Like what? Like, I don't get what people talking about. Look, he goes in here, takes a bad layup. There's two people in there. Look at this. He goes and smokes the layup. Like, bro, it's fine where it is. You shouldn't just be missing. I don't know. We just want people just to miss just because we want them to miss, I guess, man. But let me see. Mike responds and says, initial fade fix will come via patch. But after that, it will be possible to adjust independently without affecting other shot types. That's awesome. That is awesome with hot fixes. We'll be looking for feedback until almost everyone is happy. That's dope as hell. So if you would have just said this in the beginning, bro, we trying to figure out a way that we can fix this without blowing up everything else. I think everybody would have been happy, but we just didn't get that type of response or anything like that. Like I'm not gonna lie, the contested shots, I feel like if it's above like a 25% contest, if it ain't green, it probably shouldn't go in. But, you know, wide open whites, I ain't got no problem with wide open whites going in. But I just feel like if it's a good contest, you should have to green a 20, 25 or above in order to go in. I feel like, hell, maybe 15 or above. What percentage do you think it should have to be or be above in order for it to go in? I didn't anticipate the video going this long, man. Let me drop another video in here. But like, what do y'all feel like it should have to be in order for something to go in, man? Y'all let me know down in the comment section, man. I gotta find another quick video
for y'all. Another video, yeah.
You gotta have that background stuff, man. Let's just go with this right here. I don't even know what this is, but we out here. We out here. Dang it, I say we out here. But anyway, like I said, what do y'all think should be the percentage for it to be able to go in if it's contested? That's all I want to know. But it's awesome that he's saying that not only are we going to fix fades, but we're going to, I guess they're going to behind the scenes put it on a different slider. And if they put it on a different slider behind, look at Brute out here looking like Future Hendrix. If they put it on that different slider behind the scenes, then he can just turn that up or turn it down or what have you. And that's why I missed the 4% early with the green animation. And stuff like that is what burns people's bacon. Like, well, you miss like that, but then somebody hit a 38% white. Like, that's what it is. So, but like I said, that's going to be dope that they're going to be able to put it on a different slider. He said we'll be able to fix it with a hot fix after this. If he had just said from the jump, bro, you can't play defense at all. If he had just said from the jump that we're working on this and this is going to be a little bit more difficult than we initially thought, I think that nobody would have no problem with it, but like just getting radio silence for all this time is really what the problem is. Alex says, see, this is the type of stuff that I don't want to see. How about nerfing charges on next gen? Anytime I drive, majority of the time it turns into a charge animation. And it says, I'll tighten it up next week. No! You shouldn't be able to just run nilly willy nilly. Who thinks charges is a problem? I don't think charges is a problem, not even in the wreck. I probably draw one or two charges a game. But if the guy's just bulldozing and trying to bully his way through somebody, then it's like you should get a charge, regardless of if I'm moving or not. In basketball, you can't just bogard your way through me. Like if I'm here and I'm here and you still dropping your shoulder trying to run through me, there should be some penalty for it, bro. You shouldn't just be able to do anything that you want to do. I don't even see who gets charged. Hey, drop a like. Let me know if you get a lot of charges in the comment section. I draw a lot, maybe one, I get one a game pretty much, or a good offensive foul once a game. I might get two per game, but I'm definitely getting one. And that's only when the guy's just reckless or whatever, and then they'll give it to me. If the guy's extra reckless, they'll give it to me over and over. I just don't get it, man. My boy Dime, that boy Dime said, Bryant doesn't need a fix at all. Exactly. Without it, there will be no way to score. You damn right. Like it would really be difficult to score if Blinders wasn't in the game, because like I said, that one person can guard two, and it would just be crazy. And you know, it's my boy Sid677, he just says, hey, please don't touch Blinders. Scores would be in the 40s and 30s comp pro-am if you take Blinders out. You have to find a way to adjust for casual players and comp players differently. Let me say, or the game will be doomed in the future. And I truly believe that. You don't need Blinders as much in the park, but if we ain't got Blinders in pro-am, if we don't got it in rec, you damn near not gonna score, because like I said, one person can guard two, and you know, and that's how it's gonna be. One person said, contact dunks are way too common. You literally get dragged into it. Maybe add contact blocks, if you know what I mean. And he said, agreed, it's in the plans for 2K22. Ooh, look at Mike dropping leak for 2K22. Big leaks. Then where else you gonna get the biggest leaks except for right here? Big leak for 2K22. Bro, what happened right there? I just missed it. I didn't even see what happened. Like, was this the one where the dude got the offensive rebound over and over after? This is what y'all need to patch, bro. Look at this sequence. This would need to be patched. These offensive rebounds. Look at this dude. He gonna do the wrong thing over and over and get the offensive rebound. I wanna know why I saved that. Look at this interior. Miss it. Both of us there. He gets the ball. Interior. Get a block. He gets it again. Interior. Block. Can I get the ball? I still can't get the ball. This is the stuff that needs to be patched right there, Mike. Mike, I know you're listening to the video. I know you love your boy. I know you love these videos, man. Listen, that needs to be patched. People make mistakes and do the wrong thing over and over and still get the rebound. Like, come on, man. Offensive rebounds are way too common in this game. That's what we need to step up. Let me see. Hey, Mike. I'm a badge tester. This is Toos right here. I'm a badge tester, pretty much like NBA 2K Lab. A quick chat with you would be great. Got some things that might be able to fix the major issues and you know, with my testers and stuff. Yeah, he do need to talk to Toos. You know, probably about a few things. Your boy Power comes in and says, can we expect any improvements to the performance on the Xbox Series S? There have been problems, including freezing problem, unexpected error codes, the game not loading properly, blackout line, distorted players, models, and all that stuff. Yes, they, and like I said, I feel like maybe that's what they've been working on. Maybe they've been working on all this stuff, man. You know, maybe they just, look at this dude here gonna say, the dumbest idiot on the planet. You can't buy a cheap version of a console and expect the same experience 2K has to optimize just for the series to work. That's not a 2K issue, it's a system. No, you stupid motherfucker! That's a 2K issue! Imagine, do you realize how fucking stupid you are saying that? Look. What if I bought Microsoft Word, right? And I got an i7 and an i5, and it don't even work on the i5. Are you serious? How stupid? No, it's the software developers issue to make it work with as much hardware as it can. And when you only have two pieces of hardware, and the only real difference is a little RAM and the processor, no, it's on the software developer. 100%. You develop for the software that you have in front of you. And if you know anything, you know that it was developed on the Xbox Series S. So why is it not working for the one that it was actually developed for? It's created, you create for the lowest common denominator, and then you scale up based on what power you think is going to have. The developers got the Xbox Series S in order to develop ARM. That was the dev kit that they got, because they were waiting on another piece of hardware or another piece of technology to come out with the X. So it was developed for the S, and it doesn't work properly on what it was developed for. So I hate when people talk like that. There's nothing. I'm stupid. Let me see, I have no problem. And then other dudes, I'm sorry, I ain't mean to spaz like that, but I just hate when people talk about things that they have no idea about. Let me see, I have no problems with any other games. Well, exactly. I have no problems with any other game but 2K. Every other game runs smoothly, so I wouldn't say it's an S issue. The guys I run with have X and still have issues. Exactly. Stop. Get the corporate out of your mouth. I'm sorry. I can't say that. That's a hard eight times. Get the corporate PP out of your mouth. And let's hold these people accountable and make them do what they're supposed to do. Let me see, I have no problem. That's what I'm saying. Then last but not least, Swante says, Brynas does need a nerf. If there is a way to nerf OD for Park and keep it the same for Pro-Am, do that, because I guess they need Brynas. Yes, for the limited space, exactly. And then last but not least, we're gonna talk about Poor Boy Sin, what he says. I might be the only one who hasn't used Brynas once this year, so I don't even know what y'all are talking about. Let me see. It's a huge bailout out on shooting badges, honestly. Also, the contest system being so bad, that badge fits perfectly to exploit. Ain't nobody exploiting blinders. It was the same thing for years when y'all was crabbing people and shooting the ball. Now, if you get them on your hip, you can shoot the ball. Like, it's the same thing, bro. It's the same exact thing as crabbing. It ain't nothing real bad about that. Let me see what my boy said. Don't have anything on badges necessarily. But wondering if CPU control players could be given a vision or the floor for more sensational cuts? Sensible cuts to the basket and corner. Look, bro, this is what we need right here. And then our bass plug has the grind. Blah, blah, blah. Then my boy Killer, he says, please fix rebound. Thank you, Killer. He says, this is my guy. Please fix rebounding. A good box out on defensive rebounding, but it seems to find the offensive player way too much. I just showed y'all that. Just saying, even when they are in bad rebounding position, y'all just saw that. And ghost contests need to be addressed. No one near me, but I see 48% contests. Exactly. And that's probably about all we need to really talk about right there, man. Like I said, this is why Mike probably stayed away for so long, because it's like, there's people, you know, you got people that's gonna say stuff, but a lot of times what happens is we get stuff like it's OD, like everybody wants one extreme or another. Look, I got a 6'6 guard. He defends way better. He's way faster than any demigod and all of that stuff, bro. You're not getting by me with a demigod. Let's say you're gonna get by anybody. You can get by anybody in this game, right? You can always take the layup, but that's because we're crowding you, because everybody got a 95-3. So that's going to be your viable option. That's why it feels like you can't play defense, because you have to crowd everybody. But if you crowd anybody in real life, they're going to go by you. Like, that's real basketball. Like, that's where, if you crowd me, I'm going by you. You get that close, I'm whipping your arm, I'm going to the rim. And so, like, because you have to defend so hard for one thing, you have to just try to guess on the drive and hope that you get a stop here or there. That's just how the game is. But if you're playing a superstar, that's really how it's going to go. You're not going to shut anybody down. That's what I'm saying. Like, I really don't want Mike to listen to too many people, because if you listen to too many people, right, then what's going to happen is we're going to get We're going to get something that's unrecognizable for this game. But I'm just glad that Mike is back. He's tweeting, he's talking, and he's doing all this stuff, man. And maybe we'll get some change because it's been a long... I'm sorry. It's been a long time coming. It's been a long time, but I know change going to come. He didn't say, but the thing is, Mike, you tweeted, and I'm happy about that. You replied and all that good stuff. We had some numbskulls talk about some things and all that good stuff. We might make another video later on today because a lot of people were talking. I just went with the main replies. But the main thing that I want to say is just don't listen to everybody, especially the charge dude and the corporate yeah, that guy, the corporate defender. Like, bro, let's be real. It's always the software developer's issue. You're developing for three versions of hardware. I can see if it wasn't working across all these PCs, but if they can make something work across all the PCs, they can make it work on two pieces of hardware with two consoles with stagnant hardware. Just let's just be real. Anyway, man, like I said, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know what y'all think down in the comment section. If there's anything else that needs to be fixed, let me know. Drop a like on the video, and I'm holler at y'all next time. Till next time. It's your boy, Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK, the People's Champ. Godspeed.